Hey, it's Chelsea Phillips with Sounds of the Underground. Now we keep it real, real raw. And my man Rod Michael definitely did. You'll recognize him from The Voice. Check him out.
Yeah.
Okay, so you are in Germany.
Mm-hmm.
Boy band.
Yeah.
Big time. Right. I mean, you still have a huge fan base over there in Europe.
Yeah.
So, some of the fun stuff, you know? Yeah, the fun stuff.
What do you want me to say? I was doing like gangbangs all night and stuff like every night.
Yeah, like ATL Twins.
Yeah. I'm fierce and fabulous. If it ain't like me, you can't handle it. The queen and I'm running this. Step up to me, you better represent. I'm fierce and fabulous. If it ain't like me, you can't handle it.
When you first get anything first, it's the greatest thing, and it's like, I know what you're thinking. when you get anything first, it's just like, man, the first experience, it never was, my other record does after that was never the same thing, same feeling. But, you know, we drove home from New York, and we were just so stoked, so excited. And, you know, we went like celebrate, my mom got me a drink, and I was like, not underage.
That didn't happen.
Yeah, it didn't happen, yeah. Mom, I love you, you're great. No, but we thought it was to celebrate. It was the greatest feeling. We got to call everyone. It was like, we'll call you the next day. We just have to okay with the label. They trust us on the music, and they just have to okay the picture, you know, the look. Mm-hmm. They trust the producers of the group with the music. So I was like, cool. And they said, but they're going to love your look. We love your look. I'm like, okay, cool. So I was hoping. I didn't get a call for a couple of days, and then I was like, freaking out.
Were you stressing out a little bit?
Stressing out, yeah, because I thought, oh my God, telling everyone, I got a deal. Oh my God, it's amazing. I call them. And I know you're not supposed to do that, but like I call him over, hey, I just want to make sure everything's cool, you kind of set it, and like, I want to be pushy, but you know, I'm trying to like plan what I'm going to do, I have another audition, so. And they're like, no, you're perfect, they love you. They're like, oh, sorry, we were just going to call you back, so like that. I'm like, gosh. I'm like, I'm sitting here waiting, like, I'm freaking pins and needles, but he's like, no, you're perfect. We want you to get your bags packed, you're going to move into New York, we're moving to New York in our big loft. It's like $8,000 a month loft, like, oh my gosh, it was amazing. And we move here, like, we got a check for you right now for like a couple grand. Just to hold you over, then we sign the main contract, and we're gonna sign it next month. We shoot the video in a month and a half, we already have the song, you're gonna record it with the other guys, meet the other guys. It was just amazing. It was so scripted out, and like, it was amazing. It never happened like that again. It was a machine. It's like, there's some of those things get like a machine, and that's a lot of times when it works, so good.
You were with that boy band for how long?
Yeah, for 3.5 years.
B3.
For 3 years, yeah, B3, yeah.
B3.
Basically, I mean, it was just basically a music thing as a decision at the time. I mean, I got along with the guys. I love the dudes. They're like my brothers. That was the hardest thing. But musically and also performance-wise, we were kind of pigeonholed. You're in a group, it has to be what the other guys do too. You always, you know, even if you have this eccentric kind of thing, you can't really do all that when you're in a group of people that are kind of have a different lane for what they're doing. And also, our label had a genre and a sound for us. And I wasn't really quite happy with it, to be honest with you. So basically, once we had a bunch of success and we had gold record and gold album, you know, we were coming off the hottest, you know, the hottest song of the summer. So I thought it was a great time, you know, to go once, you know, leave while you're on top, because then you can go and people actually care about you. So if you leave when, you know, your record's not selling, you know, you leave a group and you try to do it, it's really hard. So, you know, basically at that time, that's why I did it. And that was the timing I did it, and basically it was just music, you know, music and performance. I was limited. I felt like I was in a box, and I got to expand when I was released. Good question. Okay. I think we've all questioned, you know, what we do for a living sometimes, right? I mean, we all question that. So basically, yeah, sometimes do I want to say, you know, fuck this shit, let me just go fly to the islands and like live in Costa Rica or something, or, you know, live in a different country or just on a more island life, more beachy. I love that. And some part of me just wants to do that, just be like incognito and just do that and not be you know, put on the face every day and be Rod Michael every day. You know, I mean, I love being who I am. I am who I am, but at the end of the day, sometimes I just want to chill the fuck out. You know, it's really, you know, it's definitely stressful and it's a lot on your shoulders. And, you know, but that's the fight in me keeps me, and I love it. It makes me happy. Music makes me happy. So as much as when it gets tough, and I want to say fuck it, then, you know, then within an hour or two, I'm like, I'm motivated, I'm back on the horse again. That's, you know, sometimes you just need to vent and breathe, and then you're good. Or you take a break. Sometimes, like, just get away for a little bit, and you just go on a little vacation to clear my mind, come back, and I'm good. I always want to stay, though. I always have the fight, and I always have the drive. That's why I'm still doing this. I've done it my whole life. So even if I go into areas of production or, you know, writing for other people and then doing my own stuff, there's branches of music where I can keep myself happy and keep it fresh. And also the... you know, the new mobile app I'm doing and stuff like that. It's basically, you know, I have a new mobile app I'm creating. It's called Fanster, and it's about to come out. I'm really excited. It's gonna connect fans with their artists to the fans directly without anything. They can just see where the shows are, see where the music's coming out. It's, you know, that kind of thing is what we need and what keeps me excited, because it's something that's missing in the market right now. So basically, all that kind of stuff. Yeah, that's so true. But, yeah, I was in the grid with Tim and John, and it was crazy over there. We just, you know, private jets. We got a first gold single, and then we got a gold album, and we just making it on the tour. I mean, you could expect it was wild, man. It was like, I mean, sometimes it would be funny. It's like, I go back to the room, I go back to the hotel, and then my road manager, phone over here. My road manager, he'd be like, he'd come in, I'd be like, okay, the other girl's waiting in the hotel room, in the hotel lobby, and I'd be like, you know, because I was young, it's my first thing, so don't judge me now. I'm a little more mature about it, so you're a little cooler about it.
No judge.
You know, my first thing, and I was handed, it's like, you know, you walk into a room and you're a kid, you get handed a buffet of food. What are you gonna do? You're freaking like, I want some of this, some of that, some of that. You know, put it on the plate. So basically, that's what I did. I was like, I'll take, man, run that, no one knows. And then, like, the manager would have it. I'd go up to the room, and there'd be, like, the girls waiting in the room. And I'd be like, oh, God. Shit. Man. So we just started having fun, man. It's like, you know, I remember, like, sometimes. I remember the one time, Tim.